everyone. So, special episode here. I'm not actually playing the footage that you're seeing right now. This is actually footage I recorded weeks ago. But as far as the upload timeline goes, this is right after part 5. So, like I decided to do earlier, I wanted to go ahead and do as much of the side questing off-panel as I could. Off-panel. What I mean is, of course, off-screen. You couldn't see my air quotes I did just then, but trust me, they were the best air quotes that have ever been done by man. So, this is actually kind of fun going back and looking at all the footage I did so long ago, not knowing what it would lead me to this day. I've actually got about 6 hours apart from this that's recorded right now, so that's going to be fun to edit. But yeah, so at the time of playing, I had just gotten to a bunch of new side quests, and I wanted to go through them without boring everyone to tears with my side questing and running back and forth, back and forth. So I just did them all off screen, recorded the footage, and that's what you're seeing right now. The first side quest marker led me to this guy, who might be one of my favorite NPCs in the entire game. He looks kind of like all the other machine enemies, except you'll notice that he has a karate gi and white headband attached. And as soon as you jump into this area, which should be like 4 tries, because you have to like get the jump pattern correct, these barriers go up and he immediately starts fighting you. We'll get to his deal as soon as he starts talking here. Oh, and I kicked his ass. So it turns out that he's this robo-monk guy who's trying to learn combat prowess. The warrior monk Father Servo. Long descendant of Tom Servo, who was not a master of karate, but had a sharp tongue regardless. So basically his side quest is that he wants to be better at fighting and achieve enlightenment through body and stuff. So he's like, fight me and beat me and then go get some parts so that I can become stronger and then fight me and beat me again and then go get parts that I might be stronger, etc., etc. And I love his whole deal where these side quests, more than any other part in the game, are really what flesh out the robots, the machines, as being more than just simple drones, if you will. Although what's interesting, what I find to be interesting, is that he has red glowing eyes. Something I've noticed over the course of playing the game is that all the quote-unquote good robots, or the robots that are not connected to the network, have green eyes. But he has red, which might have to do with him still being connected to the network. Maybe he's just operating his battle mode and that gives him red eyes. I don't know. Oh! That didn't go very well. Come on. Ass biscuit, get better. What the fuck's wrong with you? Alright, there we go. This was during my... I still kind of, it's interesting to see, I think I've upgraded my weapons since this, using different combinations. Trying to get that laser in there. Often forgetting to use my ranged attacks in these. So yeah, you beat him. You never quite get him down to 0, which is good. Yeah, okay, there he has his green eyes back. Okay, so it must be just his combat mode gives him red eyes. Yeah, so he asks for payment, and Ninus is like, what? Naomi, what? And he's all like, yeah, you fought me, and we sparred, and you have to pay me now. I'm not doing this shit for free. Luckily, I think I happen to have the wire he was looking for. Yeah, so I just give it to him immediately. And what happens is you leave the area, and you come back. And he's upgraded himself to the now being a brown belt, I believe? I can't, it's kind of a rusty brown, so it could be red. But yeah, he's now up. Oh, it's brown belt. Yep. So he's now upgraded himself to having twin axes. He has unlocked the truly devastating power that is dual wielding. And he's now also doubled his level, I think. Nope, it's tripled. He's level 30 now, I think. Yep. I'm watching this on a very tiny screen, so it's hard to tell sometimes. But he takes a little bit more damage, and he can definitely deal a lot of bit more damage, but he isn't that tough. I'm also wearing a pink bow in this scene, because this is from way, way later in the recording session. I recorded about 2 hours that I edited together into about 40 minutes by the looks of it. So you're gonna see some stuff from later in on here. But we'll get to that. So this is honestly where I began to realize that a lot of these quests are supposed to be done over the course of a period of time. I was doing these back to back to back and trying to get them all done. But as you'll see, after this is a whole new session where I find out that I was one story mission away from unlocking a whole bunch of new side quests. So despite my best attempts to do all the side quests off screen, it is unavoidable. The side quests are love, the side quests are life. Oh! He's got some cool moves. I like how he isn't just another enemy. He actually does have his own kind of style that he's working on. But it is very hard to do all these quests back to back to back. As you'll see, as he's his next form. I do beat him here. Spoilers for maybe 2 minutes here. I do beat this form, and he asks me once again to give him some new parts, he can upgrade again. And that version kicks my ass handily, and is still eluding me to this day. I have tried basically numerous times again off screen to beat him, and I'm just not. Hopefully I will get to him before ending A, which I'm actually kind of getting worried about right now. I'm not sure how this is all going to play out. There he goes. I got him. Take a nap. Alright. He's immediately like, oh, okay, now you gotta pay me again. Oh, 9S. You're so easy to play with. Everyone just manipulates you. So, yeah, he wants to get a memory alloy, which I freaked out about because memory alloy was
target location data
something from
obtained.
The previous game.
Marking on map.
But, yeah, so you come back, you upgrade him, and you leave, you come back again, and now he's in black belt form, which, I mean, that's just terrifying. He's got a tail. He's got all these weird appendages now. Oh, boy. The best part was, like I said, I recorded this weeks ago, and maybe 4 hours or so after that, I finally got to the area of the game where you fight the parts that, you basically, his body is like part of a different robot model, and they don't do any of this. So this guy's good. Yeah, he just does one kick flip, ends my life, and that's enough for that.
Hobbies anymore.
Like, I care what you think, jerk.
Oh, Jackass. How I love Jackass. So, that'll be on the back burner for a while. We move now to right outside the desert area, as I was headed to go do some side questing involving finding little sister. And, Oh, 6-0, you and your Jupiter fortune-telling. Yeah. It's occult crap. Of course it is! Aw, teary face. Poor 6-0, will she ever find love? That's the real story in this that I want to find out about. And of course, humanity, who I totally believe is actually on the moon, sending us their normal correspondence. So, Jackass wants some help from us. So, we're gonna go help Jackass. Hi, I'm 2B, and this is Jackass. And, she's basically talking, doing some experiments on combat data, which was interesting.
Here, follow me.
And, God forbid the shop owner does anything to help out. So the basic idea is she leads us over here.
See that jerk over there? I need you to get combat data for him. Science will pay you back for this, I promise. Now, fight!
Fight for science! So, yeah. At first it's pretty simple. He's a pretty tough guy, but nowhere near as tough as Father Servo. Despite being level 20. I think Father Servo's level 10 was more tough. Although, I am not dodging very well. This, it locks you into this particular screen, which makes it a little bit more difficult. Especially when you get to that bottom corner, the HUD starts really blocking everything. So she's just great, having lots of fun seeing me beat up robots. And they're all like, yeah, when you fight people, you feel love. And it's like, oh, okay. Yeah, it's romantic, me smashing these robots, jackass. Yeah. That's great. So, yeah, now we're helping out science some more. You have to get these guys beat without taking any damage. In the name of science! Which, I think this one... Yeah, I think at that point I laughed for, like, 5 seconds. This one wasn't too tough. I think I did it in the first shot. I'm not 100% sure. But I'm keeping my distance. I'm waiting for my laser to charge. I go in when they're not paying attention to me. These are all, basically, all three of these guys are as tough as the last guy. You know, so you just kind of gotta maneuver around them, keep an eye on all of them. You know, when one gets too close, dash away. It's pretty simple. It's not. Yep. That's exactly what I expected. And then she just blows them up. These poor machines, their only existence is to know death. If they don't die fighting for their lives, they die exploding. Oh, let's see how they're going to go with that. I don't think it took me too many tries. I think. Again, keeping my distance, using the laser. Simple stuff. This, of course, is before I had any of my weapons. Damn it. Try it again, 2B. At one point, these things get almost too difficult to beat, and I have to leave and come back after I've given myself some upgrades and all that. Woo! Yeah! Yeah, you don't heal after those sessions either. You have to heal yourself. So, if you take a massive hit... I almost killed Jackass there. I just drop in and stand there like, we are going to die. So that was another thing, upgrades. Something I didn't put any footage of that in there because honestly it's just me going through menus. But I did end up buying brand new weapons after this, upgrading what I could. And also buying some upgrade to pod memory. So I could, or plug-in chip memory. So that I could get a bunch of new abilities. I could have, I usually focused on defense. Though for upcoming side quests, I also did some, some movement speed, because you can have multiple different styles of chip up. So I have like one set up for my main combat, which has the health and attack. There we go, 2B. Now you got it. And then after that, I also have movement speed upgrades. Yes! Science is pleased. Intellectual, huh? What's so intellectual about us? Yeah, you know, that makes sense. Interesting. 2B is like, shut the fuck up, jackass. More data! I need more data! Yes! Keep your hands to yourself is the best way of saying no. Yep, there goes me laughing again. Alright, you've got guts, metaphorically speaking, of course. I have robo-guts. You don't know. Okay, now they want you to beat all these guys in 30 seconds or less. I think this is the first... I can take damage in this one, but I think this is the first one I actually had... I was like, there's no way I'm going to be able to do this. Because they're really tough enemies. Yeah. Yeah, no, this... I'm not doing as bad as I did last time with the whole don't take damage thing, but... Okay. Yeah, no, I got my ass kicked. Time to heal up. And yeah, I don't really even come close that time. So at that point I had left. You can tell because I now have the bow of time travel. I decided, hey, I'm gonna go power myself up. And I come back after a little. This is at this point I had gotten the Mirage pod program, which is allows you to do like a huge number of swings in a radius. So it's a really useful program for crowd control. I actually use it momentarily. Most of the time, I actually prefer to use that. Though I do switch over to my other one for long distance enemies. So yeah, that worked out pretty well. First try on my new gear, I think. I've edited this before, and it was really late at night, so I don't know. Holy crispy crap on a stick! Now this is Data. As opposed to non-crispy crap on a stick. Oh, crispy crap. Jackass, never change. Yep. Yep, without the wanton bloodlust, I probably would have stopped fighting. Yeah. I think I'm still laughing about the crispy crap joke at that point. Uh-huh. Yep, this is all fascinating stuff. Give me money. That's actually the worst part is I'm at a point now where I don't have any money because I fucking went in, bought all the weapons, and... Okay, this is assholery. So, immediately you're like, okay. Okay, so this one is beat all of the robots in 30 seconds or less, and also don't take any damage. The problem is, these are a new type of enemy, and you can see it, those sparking, glowing... They have spikes on their shields. That's me being frustrated. They have these glowing, sparking spikes on their shields. And if you touch them, you get hit. So literally just jumping into the battle is causing me to lose. So I'm like, okay, no. Oh, man. It's over in seconds, that's what I love. So I'm like, if you hit the shield at least once immediately, you can get the spikes to go away. So that's what I was trying to go for, and I think I ended up getting it to work. And of course, I've got Deadly Heal going, so I'm actually healing every time I kill one of these fools. I think this time I don't quite get it within the 30 seconds. Go for it. Go, Biscuit, go! Go, Biscuit, go! No. Oh! They just disappeared! What the hell? They're like, we're not gonna explode this time, we're just gonna transport to another dimension. Help, computer. Alright, make it happen. You got this. I believe in you, past Biscuit. Do it! Alright, so now I'm not even jumping in, I'm just circling around. I realize, oh wait, no, that's not gonna do enough damage. I gotta get in there and do damage. There goes one of them. Oh, that punched me through the robot. Start over again. God damn it. Go get that money. What the fuck are you doing? There's money on the background back there. Go get it. Okay, it's gonna be gone by the time you get down there. You jerk. Alright. Start bashing in. I get the spikes. I think I immediately started realizing that in order to get rid of those spikes immediately, I just have to start shooting when I walk in. That I think that kind of becomes the plan after this. I've also switched over to my double short swords combo, which is faster and allows me to get my ass kicked again. Oh, man. Yeah, so I go in there, I immediately get rid of the shields from the way. I run around, I use a Mirage. That's the one bad downside about Mirage, is it can leave you open once it's finished. The machines don't get... There they go again, just teleporting out of existence. The machines don't usually get stunned by Mirage the way they do, like, a heavy attack or anything. So, you've got to make sure to... Wow, 9S. He's jealous of their teleporting technology. Damn it, 9S, you made me forget my... Okay, so the Mirage doesn't stun them. But when you come out of the animation, you've got a few minutes, or like a few seconds, where you're rematerializing, and if they charge up a punch, and then, like, go for it, then you can get hit right after the animation period, which is a pain, but, you know, whatever. Oh, 5 seconds left!
Requested mission completed.
Yeah, good job. Clap, clap, clap. I knew you had a name. So, yeah, bloody hell, bloody nasty, gut-straining hell. What did you just discover? Pleasure-generating chemical produced in our circuits? What? That's crazy, jackass. Yeah, so, I haven't used this yet, out of some reason. But basically she's like, by the way, I can make a drug that's like this chemical in your body, and you can use it to give yourself a power up. So, back in the past, before the bow era, I headed back into the desert.
Pascal? Is that you?
9S. Yes, it is me. Many apologies for the sudden transmission. I heard that you were searching
for the missing child, yes? For some reason, I think there's supposed to be a filter
on Pascal's voice. Well, if you would, please consider this a personal request from myself as well.
So
go find the child as quickly as you can. She's such a good little girl. So fond of her
telling
sister.
Us to tell
she's
us, hey, go find the robot. She should be in the desert.
That's where she's likely to find the dented plate her sister.
The quest option was was on my map, but I decided to take this opportunity to go exploring the desert, and I found this area where there's a bunch of ruins and this door with this little apologizing machine in front of it. I'd heard about this. That there are these doors around where the machines are standing in front of them and are all light. They give you some reason for why you can't go in the door. I think one of them says that the area isn't ready yet, stuff like that. And then they self-destruct in apologetic fashion, and they give you some materials to upgrade. Which I will talk about in a second here, because we're about to start the next subquest. Which is the little sister.
Is that?
Aww.
Sister, where are you?
Aww. Poor little sister robot who is bigger than me. So, we're all like, hey, we're here to take you home. Let's go home and let's start this escort mission. Which is, it literally is an escort mission.
Right. Let's get her back to Pascal's village.
How'd you get lost out here anyway?
I was looking for my sister's card. But then I got scared.
Aww.
Oh, come
please
on
stop.
Now.
You're
don't cry.
My ears.
Did you at least find what you needed?
Yeah.
This is a really weird thing for an IDS.
I'm sure she will.
The mainline story
but I bet
missions,
she'll be even happier
9S
to see you back
very
home safe and sound.
To, for lack of a better word, humanizing the machines. And yet, in all of these side missions, he seems to have a soft spot, especially for this one, of being, like, really friendly towards everybody. Which is weird.
No one made the desert. It's just an area that lost all its vegetation due to a lack of precipitation.
Whee!
This caused lasting changes in the soil, which means plants aren't
9S.
Able to...
9S.
Soil? It's dirt. Ground. The stuff we're walking on?
Yes, this is just a great 9S mission. So yeah, you get a little bit, and then monsters pop out. Monsters! Again! They're not monsters, they're machines. They're not even good enough to be monsters. So, you beat them up, and they move on. So anyways, at the Apologetic Robot. And I've heard there's different maps around that have those doors. And there's always a robot that says you can't go in here for whatever reason. And from what I've heard, the main theory going around is that it's DLC, which would be pretty understandable, I think. Dragon Guard 3 had some very big DLC.
Wind is just a force caused by changes in temperature and atmospheric pressure and... Huh. That's actually a hard question now that I think about it. Kinda deep, really. I mean, where does the wind blow from? What do you think, 2B?
Don't know, don't care.
Yeah, seriously? Just shut up, Agnes. It's so deep, where does the wind come from? The wind could come from a possessed Goron sitting in front of an ice temple, barring my passage until I can transform into one of his own kind, and I wouldn't actually care where it comes from. I would just play a lullaby song on my bongo drums and make him fall asleep and fall off the cliff. Yeah, that's where the laser comes in really handy is with flying enemies, because you can basically just blow them out of the water. But now comes probably my favorite part of this mission, when we have our next conversation between 9S. I got bored and started flying and sliding around the desert.
Hey, mister, how do you make children?
Well, machines can't really make children. Neither can androids, now that I think about it.
Yeah, but how do you make them?
2B? Little help here?
Huh? You're the chatty one. Work it out.
Mister, wait! You gotta tell me how you make you...
Wow, it's getting late! Let's get you home already.
Oh, 9S. You have no problem wanting to dissect these guys, but explaining where babies come from, that's where you draw the line. So yeah, this is, I think, the last one where they summon the big guy. This is definitely the easiest of the escort missions I've come across so far. As this guy is pretty much one hell of a pushover. Oh, laser ring! I wonder if you're dumb. I'm sorry, the little crotch robot will always make me laugh. Like, I get design, like, almost every aspect of the design I'm fine with. The backpack robot, the head robot, the robots on the arms. Makes perfect sense. Dick robot, though. Dick robot is where I start asking questions. I also do love their big O arms, where they sometimes do a piston pumping punch. That's not too hard. Then they blow up, get the shit. All right, and at this point, I think we've basically done all the escort. And I'm trying to kind of get her to hurry up by running ahead of her, hoping to proc the side quest. Wait, I'm like, come on. Come on, get up there. What are you doing? Okay. Don't know what that was about. This is what, 3 weeks in the making? God. Oh no! Computer, no! Don't go to sleep, computer, just because I'm watching something for a long period of time. Just because I've been sitting here for 30 minutes and not moving the mouse at all doesn't mean I need to stop. So there's where the pink ribbon comes from. You complete the mission and she gives you her pink ribbon. Which I'm immediately like, oh my god, can I put the pink ribbon on? And I'll wait for her to leave to make sure. Oh, little sister robot.
Well, that was exhausting.
Yep.
Yep. think, like, I'm just, like, immediately, like, where's that ribbon? Where is it? Where is it? I want to be a pretty pink bow person. Key items. I'm like, where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Oh, wait, there it is! Yay! Oh, I'm so happy. Look at me. Look at me. So immediately after that, I had to go back over and fuck that guy! No reason why I did that. But this was for Jean-Paul's quest. We had to go talk to the ribbon girl. Or not, the scarf girl. I do like her style. She's got a little eye patch and the thing and everything. And I just went and talked to her. I didn't get her quest completed because I didn't want to go back to the forest and accidentally proc the quest, main quest line. So I avoided it like the plague. I also avoided the factory, which ended up being a bad idea. So now we're back on the quest for the missing resistance member. And that was tied into getting this music box from this area. So we find this dead android.
Is this the music box she was looking for? Man, this thing is all rusted over.
Look, a corpse.
Look, a corpse!
Belonged to her? Poor girl died a long time ago by the looks of it.
Let's bring this back to her friend.
You can just tell this is a female android, of course. So we get that, we go all the way back to Resistance Camp, we hand this to this lady. She's like, hey, I found it! Aw, she was dead. I'll get it working again. Yay! And, so we get that done. And now we've unlocked the next part of the Resistance Camp map, which is beyond this chain of defense. We've gotten a bunch of stuff for that mission. Like, seriously. Okay, so we can now move forward. So we go in here, and there's nothing done here yet, but we'll be back here next time. Aw, that music is so pretty. I love the music cues in this. Have I mentioned that enough? Have I taken enough time out of my busy day to say, fuck, man, this music is really fucking good? I'm sure everyone loves to hear about it.
So if we use those numbers from the resistance,
so at the bottom of the one of the things is a bunch of numbers. You're right, like, hey, look, it's coordinates, and you're all like, hey, okay, that's cool. So we go to where the coordinates are, and I fucking die like 5 million goddamn times. Not from these guys. These guys are tough but manageable. They're a little bit of a stronger enemy type with these razor blades than. The only reason why they really gave me too much trouble is I didn't know what their moves were. But once I figured it out, I was able to take care of them pretty easily. And I was like, okay. So normally what I would do is I would head immediately into the little side pass that you actually have to go into. But if you do that, these assholes on the other side of this little crevasse will come in and ruin your day more while you're dealing with whatever is going on down there. We'll get to it. This is actually something I'm really, really having a problem with in this game. Probably the only thing I can say is a noticeable problem. And that is, there are several occasions where a creature will be a robot will be level 10, level 20, but it'll be stronger than some, like, level 40 creatures I'm fighting. Creatures! Creature! Feature! Creature! Nah! So that's me retrieving my body from last time. Yeah, I've cut out all of my utter complete failures. Luckily, he hit me really hard, but I leveled up right afterwards. So, this fucking guy kicked my ass from both tree posts, like, 5 times. That's why I'm trying to keep my distance from him as much as possible. And I might as well have currently taped down my R1 button, because I was not letting up when firing on it. And I wouldn't even use the Mirage, because I was like, I wanna hit him once or twice and then back off. Hit and fade. Do not let him get a hit on me, because it'll take off like half my health. And he has a couple different combo maneuvers. Yeah, dodge. Good dodge. Good dodge. And yeah, he's like, what, level 35. And the guys out front were like level 20, I think. And I get it. I'm level 14. I'm not that tough yet. They ain't sweating my level 14 ass. But I don't even get like a lot of experience from these guys anymore. Like, it's not like going around and grinding up levels is going to make me necessarily better at this, is my point. Especially in another section where they're like enemies that I'm on the same level as, and they're taking zero damage because they're some kind of superpowered robots, Mega Man, if you will. As you see, I'm actually kind of avoiding using my multi-hit combos. I think at one point I give up on this and go directly for the twin swords. Get out of there. There you go. Dodge. Good dodge. Taking my path to myself. But yeah, this crush was easy. And it's ultimately a very sad one, too. Given enough time and determination, you can take pretty much anything now. Boosh! That laser is really effective. You know, when you're doing single target enemies, you want to be using that laser as much as possible. The Mirage helps, like I said, on crowd control, but the power laser is where it's at. So after this, like I said, there's another area of the game where I come into a bunch of side quests. I'm going to let this battle play out. And I'm not going to cut them together like this because I was in the middle of a session. I mean, I basically was like, I'm just going to keep going.
Analyze this machine.
I'll cut. There's some editing I have to do.
Call it professional curiosity.
Analysis.
Yeah, some tubies.
This machine life forms comrades were destroyed.
Yeah.
Driven by that grudge, it lured a resistance member to this location. It then proceeded to destroy him.
Are you saying this thing wanted revenge?
It wanted revenge!
That concept is far too complex.
9S! We just got done escorting a robot who wanted to know what babies were. Okay? Quit fucking saying it's too complex for
this corpse. I wonder if it's the resistance member we're looking for. Let's check his memory.
Probably
seems this
is.
One came here looking for revenge.
Yeah. I guess the weaker
so,
one lost.
Yeah. Basically, it's they killed my robot friends. I'ma kill him. And then it's like, oh, he killed my android friend.
I really hate this. I'm going to feel terrible telling that woman what happened to her friend.
It's the truth. She has to know.
No matter what that truth actually is.
So this is basically setting up for the idea that you can tell her that the guy is lost forever, or you can tell her where he went and what happened to him. I opt for the first option. I tell her the truth because I feel like that's not my place. Especially considering, I mean, what? You're going to just have the guy forgotten for all time? That's terrible. Yeah, I do like that 9S is like, you really please don't go for revenge. Please. Don't do it. Don't you dare do it. She did it. So you come back and this guy's all like, yeah, she left to go fight. And yeah, she gives you a bunch of stuff. And that's it. That was the last side quest. Kind of a sad note to go out on. But, you know, that's just how this world goes. Ooh.